वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी कोल्हे, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, सीओजी कॉलेज कन्नड, डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरेंस। सो फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट इज फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरेंस? वी ऑलवेज से दैट समथिंग इज मूविंग, समथिंग इज इन मोशन, सो वी मीन टू से दैट इट्स पोजिशन इज चेंजिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू समथिंग एल्स। It may be an object or environment that is considered to be stationary. So in this image we can see the ball is rolling down the street. Here the street is frame of reference, and with respect to this frame of reference street, we can describe the motion of the ball. So we need frame of reference as a street to describe the motion of the ball. So earth is treated, used as frame of reference, though it is in motion. So a well-defined coordinate system in which velocity of the object can be clearly described is known as frame of reference. Friends, suppose a particle is at P. Now we can specify its position by using x, y, z coordinates and also t coordinate, means at which time the particle is at which position, we can describe using that frame of reference. So see, in this image a carriage is there which is moving with constant velocity v, and inside the carriage A and B are there, and see the man outside the carriage. Now see here, the carriage is in motion. It is moving with constant velocity, uniform velocity v. If we ask the man A about motion of this B man, about status of this B man, then A can say the B man is at rest because they are both in same carriage and the carriage is in uniform motion. So he can say like that. But if you ask man C outside the carriage about position motion of this B man, then C can say the B man is in motion with velocity v. So this change is due to frame of reference, because A and B are in same frame of reference, C is outside that carriage. So friends, inertial frame of reference is that frame. It is either at rest or moving with velocity, constant velocity. So if the carriage is at rest, or if it is moving with constant velocity with respect to this frame of reference in which the boy or man C is there. So in case of this inertial frame of reference, suppose this carriage is at rest, then A or B man is they are at rest, and they will remain at rest until and unless we apply force on that. Suppose A is the object or B is the object, they are at rest without application of that force. But if the carriage is moving and if it is accelerating, then the both objects A and B experience force, they can change their position because that acceleration, because changing velocity with respect to time. So this is violation of Newton's first law of motion. Without we are not applying force on that A and B objects. So that retarding accelerating frame of reference is inertial, not non-inertial frame of reference. But if the A and B are at rest because carriage is at rest, then if we don't apply force on A and A or B, then they will not change their position, they will not move. So this is inertial frame of reference. It obeys Newton's first law of motion, first law of inertia. So it is defined as frame of reference in which Newton's first law of motion holds. It is so non-inertial frame of reference, frame of reference that is accelerated with respect to assumed inertial frame of reference. retarding carriage with the ball inside it. So we have seen that carriage. If the carriage inside there is a ball, it is kept, the ball will remain at rest if the carriage is at rest, or if the carriage is in uniform motion, the ball will remain at rest. If the carriage retards, then the ball will change its position without application of external force. This is violation of Newton's first law of motion, law of inertia. So it is, in this case, it is non-inertial frame of reference. Now friends, we will see Galilean transformation equation. See, in this figure, S and S dash are two inertial frame of reference. This S frame of reference, there are x, y, z coordinates, and this S dash frame of reference, there are x dash, y dash, z dash coordinates. So S at rest and S dash is in uniform motion with respect to S frame of reference. S dash is moving with velocity v with respect to S frame of reference. Now event occurs at P. Here at P the event occurs. Its coordinate with respect to S frame of reference are x, y, z. And with respect to S dash frame of reference, they are x dash, y dash, z dash. And also if you use T coordinate, then time coordinate with respect to this S frame is T, and with respect to this S dash frame is T dash. Now observer at O and O dash. Now distance traveled by S dash in positive S direction in time T is Vt. See here, this Vt distance. X coordinates of two frames differ by Vt. So X dash is equal to X minus Vt, Y dash is equal to Y, Z dash is equal to Z, T dash is equal to T. Now inverse transformations will be X is equal to X dash plus Vt, Y is equal to Y dash, Z is equal to Z dash, T is equal to T dash. Now transformations of velocities from one to another system, dx dash by dt is equal to dx by dt minus v. This is change in position with respect to time, that is, it is velocity. In velocity, in S dash, velocity in S frame minus v. That is, u dash is equal to u minus v. Dy dash is equal upon dt is equal to dy by dt. Dz dash by dt is equal to dz by dt. Accelerations are a and a dash in S and a dash frame of reference. So acceleration, change in velocity with respect to time. In S frame, it is a. In a dash frame, acceleration a dash is du dash by dt. As u dash is equal to u minus v. So du dash by dt is equal to du by dt. As v is constant. References are used for preparation of this problem presentation. Thank you.